Okay, good day, students. I am Mr. Goyo, your mathematics teacher for this school year.
Good day, students. For this week, we will discuss all about permutation. Okay, so before we start the discussion about permutation, so let's have a knowledge first all about the factorial notation. Okay, so kapag sinabi kasi nating factorial notation, this is where n is a non-negative integer. So ibig sabihin sa factorial notation, all numbers are positive integers. And a factorial notation is written in this symbol like n factorial, or this symbol, this read as the n factorial. It is defined as the product of all positive integers from 1 to n, or from n to 1. So kung mapapansin natin, no, yung n factorial natin, it is from n times n minus 1, tapos yung n number niya is 1. Hindi ka pwedeng magkaroon ng 0 dito. Okay, kasi kapag naging 0 siya, alam naman natin that any number is multiplied by 0, this will become 0. Eh sir, what if magkaroon tayo ng 0 factorial? Always remember that 0 factorial is always equal to 1. Okay? So, para maganda, let's have some examples about factorial notation. For example, let's say we need to find 3 factorial. Sabi natin kanina, yung n factorial natin is n times n minus 1, n minus 2, hanggang mag-n sa 1. Okay, so kung meron tayong 3 factorial, meaning meron tayong 3, no? Start tayo dun sa number natin or sa given natin, 3 times 2 times 1. Now, kung mapapansin ninyo, no, magde-depreciate lang siya ng 1 or magde-decrease lang siya ng 1, no, hanggang sa ma-reach natin yung lowest number, which is 1. So, kapag kinuha natin yung product nito, 3 times 2 is 6 times 1 is also 6. So, meaning, 3 factorial is equal to 6. So, ganun lang kasimple yung factorial notation. So, another example, let's say meron tayo ritong 4 factorial. Okay, 4 factorial. So, kapag sinabi natin 4 factorial, so, balikan lang natin yung ginawa natin kanina. So, this will become 4, no? Which is the first number natin. Then, minus 1 tayo. 4 minus 1, you have 3. Then, times. Then, 3 minus 1, 2. No? Times, 2 minus 1 is 1. Okay, so, kung mapapansin nyo, hanggang 1 lang tayo lagi. So, we have 4 times 3. We have 12. Then, times 2. We have 24, then times 1 is also 24. So, meaning, 4 factorial is equal to 24. Alright, so kung marunong naman kayo sa mental calculations, much better, no? Pwede nyo isolve to using mental calculations. Or kung meron naman kayong calculator sa bahay, pwede nyo rin magamit yung calculator. Okay, so let's have another example. Let's say we have here 5 factorial. Okay, so 5 factorial, so ganun lang ulit. So 5 times 4, no? Minus 1, then times 3, times 2, then times 1. So kapag minultiply natin yan, 5 times 4 will give you 20, no? Times 3, 60. Times 2, 120, and times 1, 120. So, meaning, 5 factorial is equal to 120. Okay. So, what if ganito naman yung problem? Let's say meron tayong 5 factorial, no, plus 3 factorial. So, kailangan ba natin i-add yung 5 plus 3? So, hindi, no? Kailangan lang natin ulit i-apply yung factorial notation process bago tayo mag-add. So, syempre, yung 5 factorial, this is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So, ito yung 5 factorial natin. Plus, yung 3 factorial natin, 3 times 2 times 1. Okay? Then, alam natin na yung 5 factorial natin kanina is 120 plus yung 3 factorial natin is 6. So, therefore, 5 factorial plus 3 factorial is equal to 126. And, okay? Okay, so paano naman, no? So, paano naman kung maka-encounter tayo ng ganitong klaseng problem? Let's say, 4 factorial times, no? Times 2 factorial. So, same process pa rin. Ganun lang muna gagawin natin. Kunin natin yung factorial notation ng bawat given. 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Ito yung 4 factorial natin. Tapos, yung 2 factorial natin, 2 times 1. Okay, yung 4 factorial natin, 4 times 3 is 12. Times 2, 24. Times 1 is also 24. So, 24 times 2 times 1 is 2. So, this will give you 48. So, meaning, 4 factorial times 2 factorial is equal to 48. Okay? So, another. So, what if ganito naman? 5 factorial divide 3 factorial. So, still, apply natin yung process, no? 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 divide by 3 times 2 times 1. So, dito sa process na to, pwedeng ang gawin nyo rito, i-multiply muna natin to. Oh, di ba? Meron tayo rito 120 divide 6. No? At yung magiging sagot natin dito is 20. Right? Pwede rin naman mangyari, pwede kayong gumamit ng cancellation method. So, paano yung cancellation method? So, let's say ito siya. 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Then, 3 times 2 times 1. Kunyari, ito siya. Kung mapapansin naman natin, parehas may 3 times 2 times 1, diba? So, itong 3 times 2 times 1 yan, pwede na natin siyang makancel out. Okay? Therefore, 5 factorial over 3 factorial will give you 5 times 4 is 20. Okay? Okay, so ngayon naman, itry natin yung permutation of an object. No? So, sa permutation of an object kasi, meron tayong theory na kailangan sundin. So, una, now the first theorem here is the number of permutation n of distinct object is n factorial. So, meaning, ito yung arrangement nung isang object or nung mga object without any forms of conditions. For example, meron tayong limang object at kailangan nating kunin yung different or yung all possible arrangements nila or kailangan nating malaman ilan yung possible arrangements nila. So, we'll just simply use the n factorial. Okay? Then, for permutation of an object taken R at a time, ito naman yung kapag meron tayong condition. For example, meron tayong object at kailangan nating kunin yung permutations or arrangements niya with a certain condition. For example, taken 2 at a time. So, lima yung object, kailangan mong kumuha ng arrangement or alamin yung total possible number of arrangement na sa bawat arrangement, dalawang object lang. No? Pwede rin taken 3, taken 4, depende. As long as na yung taken mo or yung representation ng R mo ay hindi mas malaki dun sa number of objects. Okay, so later magkakaroon tayo ng example dyan. Okay, for this theorem, sabi rito, kaya ito yung tatandaan nyo yung formula natin dito na gagamitin. The number of permutations of n distinct objects taken R at a time denoted as ito, yung P N R. No? So, permutation of n taken r. So, ganun natin siya babasahin. So, p permutation of n or permutation of n taken r, no, is written in the form of, eting formula ang gagamitin natin, no? Permutation of n taken r is equal to n factorial. Ito yung total number of total possible number of arrangements ng isang object over n minus r factorial. Ito naman yung magiging condition kung ilan lang bawat arrangement, no, ng object na meron tayo. Okay, so try natin sa next slide for our example. Okay, remember the formula. Okay, so ito yung formula na yung ito yung example natin for permutation of an object, no? So for example here, no, meron tayong 3 examples, no? Permutation of 5 taken 2. So kunyari meron tayong 5 object and we need to arrange them 2 at a time, no? Ilan kaya yung possible arrangement na magagawa natin or permutations? Permutation 7 taken 3 and permutation 10 taken 4. Okay, so mas maganda kung meron kayong calculator to solve this. Okay, so let's try to answer this one. So, simulan muna natin sa letter A. Okay, so again, sabi dun kanina sa theorem natin, the formula should be P, no? N taken R is equal to N factorial over N minus R factorial. Okay, yung n natin dito, madali lang naman malaman kung ano yung n natin. Yung n natin dito, syempre, yung mas malalaki yung value. No, para hindi tayo malito. No, yung highest value dyan, yun yung stands for n natin. Siya yung n natin. Then, yung 2, yung lowest value here, siya naman yung, ano natin, yung pinaka magiging condition natin or yung r natin sa permutation. So, simulan natin sa letter A. Sa letter A, ang n natin is 5. At yung r natin is 2. So, try natin hanapin yung permutation of an object for this given, no? So, gamit tayo ng formula, P. No? Just simply follow this, ano, this method or this process, no? Ang n natin ay 5. Ang r natin ay 2. So, meron tayo rito ang 5 factorial over, no? Yung n natin ay 5 minus 2 factorial. So, kung alam nyo na kung meron naman kayong calculator, pwede nyo itong i-direct, no, yung 5 factorial natin. Pero mamaya natin siya i-solve. So, unahin natin yung nasa ibaba. So, meron tayong 5 factorial over 5 minus 2 will give you 3. E may factorial notation tayo sa labas, so magiging 3 factorial. Okay? So, kung meron kayong calculator, pwede nyo i-solve to directly. Pero kung wala, gamitin natin itong manual computation method. Okay? So, yung 5 factorial natin, sabi natin kanina, this is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Okay? Then, yung 3 factorial natin, 3 times 2 times 1. Kaya ng example natin kanina, pwede kayong i-direct solution nyo muna. Or pwede tayong gumamit ng cancellation method para mas madali yung process natin. So, dahil parehas naman itong merong 3 times 2 times 1, pwede natin i-cancel out yung 3 times 2 times 1. So, ang matitira sa atin is 5 times 4. So, meaning, permutation of 5 taken 2 will give you 5 times 4 is 20. Okay? Again, kung meron kayong calculator, simple lang naman. Kung may calculator kayo, alam natin, 5 factorial will give you 120 and 3 factorial will give you 6. So, kapag dinivide natin to, ito pa rin naman yung sagot. Alright? So, try natin yung letter B. Okay, sabi sa letter B, ang n natin dito ay 7, ang r natin ay 3. Alright? So, gamitin natin yung formula. So, P 7 taken 3 is equal to, yan, is equal to 7 factorial, okay, over 7 minus 3 factorial. Okay? Then, so 7 minus 3 muna tayo. Magkakaroon tayo ng 7 factorial over 7 minus 3 will give you 4 factorial. Okay, so kunyari, wala tayong calculator pa rin. Huwag muna natin siya i-direct. Gamit tayo ng manual computation. So, yung 7, 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Okay, tapos yung 4 factorial natin, 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Okay, so dahil wala tayong calculator, so, gamit tayo ng cancellation method para mas madali. Cancel out natin yung 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. No? Kasi pareha sila nung nasa denominator. Tapos, yung matitira, siya na lang yung i-multiply natin. Okay? So, ang mangyayari dyan, 7 times 6, then times 5. So, kapag minultiply natin yan, 7 taken 3, no? Permutation of 7 taken 3 will give you 210. Right? So, ganun lang siya kasimple. Okay, so last example tayo. Ito. Okay, so ito kasi medyo malaki lang ito. So, letter C. Ang N natin dito is 10. Ang R natin is 4. So, again, using the formula, 10 taken 4 is equal to 10 factorial over 10 minus 4 factorial. So, still, sundin natin yung process mula nung una. Meron tayong 10 factorial over 10 minus 4 will give you 6 factorial. Okay? So, pahabain ulit natin. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yan. Okay? Tapos yung nasa baba, 6 factorial, you have 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Okay. So, kunin ulit natin yung mga magkakaparehas. Cancel out natin. No, pare-parehas yung 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So, cancel out natin yung 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ang matitira sa atin ay yung 10 times 9 times 8 times 7. So, kapag minultiply natin yun, simple lang, 10 times 9, then times 8, times 7, no? Ang magiging sagot natin dito is 5,040. So, ito yung permutation of 10 taken 4. Okay. So, kung mahina tayo sa mental calculation, I suggest na pwede naman kayong gumamit ng calculator. Okay, basta susundin lang din natin yung process. Okay, class. So, what if naman sa permutation ay maka-encounter tayo ng ganitong klaseng problem? No? So, sabi rito, find the value of R so that the permutation of 7 taken R is equal to 840. So, sabi, yung 7 taken R daw, the result is 840. Ang problem kasi natin dito is wala yung R. No? So, paano kayong gagawin natin para ma-identify natin yung value ng R? So, ganito lang yung gagawin nyo kapag you are looking for the value of your R sa permutation. Okay? So, madali lang to pagdating sa permutation. So, una, syempre, alam natin that the formula is P, no? N taken R is equal to N factorial over N minus R factorial. Sa given na to, no, meron tayong value ng n, no, ito 'yun. Meron tayong value ng pn ng pnr, ito naman 'yun. Ang wala lang talaga tayo value ng r. Okay, so sulat natin yung mga given. Meron tayong value ng n taken r, which is yung 840. Meron tayong value ng n, which is 7. Ang unknown natin dito is yung value ng R. So, paano yung process? So, susundan nyo lang itong process ko para mas madali, no? Una, ilagay muna natin ano ba yung value ng P n taken R. So, yung P n taken R is 840. no, equals, no, gagamitin lang din natin yung formula. No, yung n natin dito is 7, so meron tayong 7 factorial over, no, meron tayong 7 minus r, kasi unknown yung r factorial. Okay, so una, kunin muna natin yung value ng 7 factorial. No? Pag 7 factorial, di ba, meron tayong, unamahin natin to, 840. Di ba yung 7 factorial is 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Over, ito kasi, kukopihin lang natin yan. Wala tayong magagawa dyan eh. 7 minus r factorial. So, kunin natin yung product nito. 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. No? Yung 7 factorial natin is equal sa 5,040. So, kung gusto nyo, pwede nyo namang i-double check using your calculator. Pero maganda, yung mga small numbers or single digit ng factorial notation is makabisado natin. Okay, so ngayon, eto na siya. So, gagawin natin ngayon, we need to apply the cross-multiplication process. No? Kasi, kailangan natin makuha yung value ng r. Pero kung para hindi mas matagal, para madali lang, i-switch natin yung position ng denominator at ng 840. No? Switch lang natin sila para mas madali. No? So, mangyayari, 7 minus r, sorry, burahin natin to. Ayusin natin. No? 7 minus r factorial is equal to itong 5,040 divide 840. So, you can use calculator para ma-divide niya yan, no? So, 5,040 divide 840. No? Kapag ginamitan niyo ng calculator, ang mangyayari, 7 minus r factorial is equal to 6. So, yan na. Malapit na natin makuha yung tamang sagot. So, ngayon, anong next na gagawin natin? No? So, simple lang. Di ba yung 6 is pwede natin siya isulat ng factorial form. Di ba? Or into factorial notation. Dahil yung 6, alam natin, this is 3 times 2 times 1. Tama. Or, pwede natin siyang isulat. We have 7 minus r, no, factorial. Yung 3 times 2 times 1 is 3 factorial. Okay? So, ano ngayon yung parehas na meron sila? So, kung mapapansin nyo, ngayon, meron tayong pwedeng i-remove dito. Dahil meron silang parehas na factorial notation. So, i-remove natin yung factorial notation. Ang matitira ay 7 minus r. Sorry, tanggal natin parenthesis. No, 7 minus r is equal to 3. Then, apply tayo ng double transposition method. Transpose natin si negative r papunta sa right at si positive 3 papunta sa left. No? Alam naman natin yung concept ng or yung rule ng transposition method. Kapag nilipat natin siya ng pwesto at tumawid siya sa equal sign, magchi-change siya ng sign. So, ibig sabihin, 7, yung positive 3, magiging negative 3. Yung negative r, magiging positive r. Then, 7 minus 3 is 4, is equal to r. Or pwede rin natin sabihin that r is equal to 4. Okay? So, pwede yung sundan yung process. Okay, so what if naman, no? So what if sa permutation ang ma-encounter niyo naman ang nawawala is yung n. No? What if yung n naman yung nawawala? Paano yung magiging process natin? So ito medyo iba-iba naman yung magiging process nito unlike dun sa kapag nawawala yung r sa permutation. Okay? So try natin, then after this siguro pag naka-encounter kayo ng ganitong klase ng problem, just follow kung ano yung process na ginawa ko. Okay? So, kung may mas mabilis na paraan, pwede ko rin ma-share sa inyo. Pero for now, ito muna yung gagamitin nating process. So we all know na yung formula natin is PNR is equal to N factorial over N minus R factorial. No? So gagamitin kasi natin lagi yung formula kasi sa kanya tayo mag-base. So meron tayo rito ang value ng permutation N taken R, which is 90. Meron, wala yung value ng N natin, pero meron tayong value ng R, which is 2. So, try natin ngayon hanapin yung value ng N. Okay, so substitute natin yung mga corresponding value. So, meron tayong 90. N is unknown over meron tayong N minus 2 factorial. So, yung paano yung gagawin natin dito? Wala tayong pwedeng i-cancel out. Okay. So, balik tayo ron sa definition ng N factorial. Diba? Sabi natin, yung N factorial is N times N minus 1, N minus 2, dot, 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 up to 3, times 2, times 1. Okay. Kung mapapansin nyo, meron tayong N minus 2 factorial. Diba? So, ibig sabihin, itong N minus 2 hanggang 1, pwede natin to i-convert into factorial notation. Okay, co-convert natin siya into factorial notation kasi alam naman natin na itong part na to ay hanggang 1. Okay, so paano yung gagawin natin? Meron tayong 90 is equal to, syempre yung naunang dalawa, yung N times N minus 1, kasi kapag dinare-diretso natin yan hanggang 1, so mahaba lang siya. E meron naman tayong N minus 2, then end natin siya ng factorial. N minus 2 factorial. So, dito pa lang, pwede na tayong makapag-cancel out ng N minus 2 factorial kasi mula dito hanggang 1, same lang naman to. Kapag nag-minus 1 tayo nang nag-minus 1 dyan. Kasi, diba, next nito, N minus 3, N minus 4, blah, 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 hanggang makarating tayo kay 1. So, ganun din to. Okay? So, meron tayong yung mga cancel out, yung N minus 2 factorial. Cancel out natin siya. Alright, ang matitira ngayon, yung 90 is equal to N times N minus 1. Okay, so may napapansin na ba kayo sa given? Yes, exactly, no? Para siyang magiging quadratic equation. No? Kapag dinistribute natin yung N dun sa loob ng parenthesis. So, let's start. So, 90 is equal to N times N. We have N squared. Then, N minus 1 will give you N. So, para maging quadratic na siya, itong 90, transpose na natin dito sa right side. So, ang mangyayari ngayon, we have N squared minus N minus 90 is equal to 0. Okay, then apply tayo ng factoring method. Okay, factor tayo, equals 0. Okay, di ba yung technique kapag nakita natin na ang isang quadratic ay minus minus, dapat dyan ay plus minus. So, yung N natin, dahil N squared yan, meron tayong N and N. So, ngayon, balik tayo sa basic ng factoring method. No? Think a number, no? Two numbers, na ang product ay 90, pero ang sum niya ay negative 1. Product ay 90, ang sum ay negative 1. So, para makakuha tayo ng 90, yung pinakamadali, meron tayong 10 at 9. No, yun na yung pinakamadali natin kasi 10 times 9 is 90. No? Pero kailangan natin daw ay negative 1. So, para maging negative 90 rin to, kailangan yung isa sa kanila ay negative. So, kapag yung 9 ang negative, kapag in-add mo sila, magbibigay sa'yo ng positive 1. So, hindi tayo o hindi natin makukuha itong rule na to. No? So, kailangan ang magiging negative ay yung 10. So, meaning, meron tayong N plus 9 and N minus 10. So, ngayon, try na natin hanapin yung value ng N na kailangan natin dito sa given na to. Equate natin bawat factor into 0. So, meron tayong N plus 9 is equal to 0. Transpose natin yung 9. Magkakaroon tayo ng N is equal to positive. Pag nilipat, magiging negative. Okay, yung isa naman, N minus 10 equals 0. Transpose natin yung negative 10. N is equal to positive 10. Ngayon, ang question, alin sa dalawa yung value ng n? Okay. Diba sabi sa definition natin, in permutation or factorial notation, n is always positive integers. So, meaning, ito yung value ng n na hinahanap natin. So, meaning, the main given here is p, 10 taken 2 is equal to 90. Right? Okay, so let's have another example here of permutation. So, try natin sagutan tong problem na to. Sabi rito, in how many possible ways can Mr. Mathusay assign 6 different activities? Okay, in his 4 students in grade 10. Okay, so sabi ko kanina, no, sa permutation of an object, kung ano yung higher number or yung mas malaking number, siya yung number of objects na meron tayo. No? Or, ayun yung pinaka main given natin. Okay, so dito, our n here, no, is 6. So, yung condition natin dito is yung number of students. So, yung r natin is equal to 4. So, ngayon, try natin alamin ilan ba yung possible ways daw na yung 6 activities ay mabibigay ni Mr. Mathusay sa kanyang 4 students. No, na ma-assign yung 6 activities sa kanyang 4 students. So, again, let us try to use the formula. We have n taken r is equal to n factorial over n minus r factorial. Okay? So, substitute natin yung mga corresponding value. P, 6 taken 4 is equal to 6 factorial over 6 minus 4 factorial. Okay? So, magkakaroon tayo ngayon ng 6 factorial over 6 minus 4 will give you 2 factorial. Okay, so next, magkakaroon tayo ng expand natin siya gamit tayo ng yung long method kanina, no? Meron tayong 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Kasi wala tayong calculator kunyari, no? So expand natin siya. Then yung 2 factorial, you have 2 times 1. Okay? So, meron tayong common factor with dito which is 2 times 1. No? Tanggalin natin siya yung 2 times 1 natin. Alright? So, then multiply natin siya. 6 times 5 times 4 times 3. Okay? So, the permutation of 6 taken 4 is equal to, no? Magbibigay siya ng 360. So, ganun lang siya kasimple. Okay? Okay. So, next one here is what we call the circular permutation. Okay, so sa circular permutation, madali naman lang din to. Explain natin sa madaling paraan. Okay. Sa circular permutation kasi, ang ginagawa lang natin dito is same as in permutation. No, kaya lang, the only difference is meron siyang condition kung saan nakapwesto, no, yung mga tao. Okay? So, this circular permutation, imagine that you are sitting in a round table. No, nakapaikot kayo sa isang round table and yung problem dito is you need to identify the number of possible ways kung ilang beses kayo nila pwedeng i-arrange. So, ganun yung certain rule ni circular permutation. Actually, naging circular permutation lang naman to, hindi porket circular permutation is sa circular table lang siya pwedeng mangyari. Okay, pwede rin siyang mangyari in any forms of tables. Okay? Hindi naman kayo nakapila rito. Okay, for circular permutation. Okay. So, the only thing we need to use the formula of n minus 1 factorial. Bakit may minus 1? Kasi try to imagine na lahat kayong magkakaibigan ay nakaupo sa isang round table tapos magkakaroon kayo ng experiment ilan yung possible arrangement. Ang mapapansin mo doon kapag ginawa mo yung experiment, may isa sa inyo na parang hindi gumagalaw. Parang lang ha, imagine na parang hindi lang siya gumagalaw. No? Ibig sabihin, yung tao na yon, no? O yung object na yun, o yung tao na yon ay babalik at babalik dun sa naging pwesto niya. Okay? Kaya nagkaroon tayo ng n minus 1 factorial. Pero kapag meron naman tayo natawag na distinct object sa permutation, doon naman natin gagamitin yung formula ng permutation kanina na ginamit natin, then divide by r. Pero dito muna tayo ngayon mag-focus. Alright? Okay. So, let's have an example about circular permutation. Okay? So, for example here, sabi rito, 5 people are to be seated at a round table. How many different arrangements are possible? So, ito yung sinasabi natin kanina, no? So, 5 people are seated at a round table. So, ilan kayong possible arrangement na pwede nating magawa sa kanila? Diba, sa permutation natin ng circular permutation, we have n minus 1 factorial. No? So, ang n natin dito, syempre yung 5 people. So, yung n natin is equal to 5. So, kunin natin yung circular permutation. Nakalimutan ko lagi ng equals. No? Circular permutation is equal to n minus 1 factorial. Alright? So, substitute lang natin yung value. Meron tayong 5 minus 1 factorial. It will give you 4 factorial. No? So, ilan ba yung 4 factorial natin? So, yung 4 factorial natin, no, for circular permutation, ang 4 factorial natin is 24. So, ganun kadali si circular permutation. Eh, what if? Okay, may ganitong instance. What if we have 5 people are seated at the round table tapos nagkaroon tayo ng condition, no? If, kunyari lang, dugtong natin to. If 2 people are seated beside each other, no? Parang ganun. 2 people seated beside each other. Tama ba yung term natin? Beside each other. Basta magkatabi. No? Kunyari magkatabi yung dalawang tao. So, paano yung gagawin natin kung magkatabi sila? So, kailangan daw yung dalawang tao. Kunyari, gawa natin ng diagram. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Kunyari, ito yung limang tao na yun. No? Ang condition ngayon, kailangan daw magkatabi yung dalawang tao. So, paano mangyayari? So, kapag naka-encounter kayo ng ganitong klase ng permutation, simple lang yung gagawin natin. No? Imagine na itong taong to, itong dalawang to, will be considered as 1. So, ngayon, instead of 5, no? Instead of 5, yung n natin dito, magiging 4 na lang. Kaya lang, okay, meron tayong kaya lang. Kaya lang, alam naman natin na itong taong to, no, itong dalawang to, pwedeng magpalit ng pwesto. Okay? Pwedeng magpalit to ng pwesto. So, paano yung mangyayari sa equation natin dito? So, ang mangyayari sa circular permutation natin, no, we have 4 minus 1 factorial. Itong 4 na to, ito yan. Itong lahat sila. Kasi kinonsider natin na isa yung dalawang tao. Times. Yan. Meron tayong dalawang tao rito na pwede pang rearrange. So, pwedeng mangyari sa kanya, times 2 factorial. So, kung tatlo yan, magiging 3 factorial. Okay, so let us try to solve this. So, 4 minus 1 will give you 3 factorial times 2 factorial. So, yung 3 factorial natin, alam natin, this is 3 times 2 times 1. No, yung 2 factorial natin, 2 times 1. Okay, yung 3 factorial will give you 6. Yung 2 factorial will give you 2. So, meaning, yung permutation, or yung circular permutation natin, kapag magkatabi ng dalawang tao, will give you 12. Okay? So, ganun siya. So, kung tatlo yan, magiging 3 factorial, then count na lang sila. Okay? That's an example of circular permutation. Okay, so, last one here is the what we called arrangement with repetition. Ito yung form ng permutation na merong nauulit. commonly nagagamit to sa mga words. Okay, numbers. Ito yung may mga nauulit na object. Or commonly, mas kilala tong permutation na to sa natawag na distinguishable permutation. Okay, sabi rito sa theorem niya, sabi, if there are n objects with R sub 1 of type 1, R sub 2, type 2, and R sub M of type M, ito yung mga ilang, meaning nito, ito yung mga naulit na object. No? So, for distinguishable permutation, no, we need to use the formula n factorial times R sub 1 factorial, R sub 2 factorial, up to R sub M factorial. Okay, so meaning, ito yung mga nauulit na object. Okay, so para mas maintindihan natin, let's have an example of distinguishable permutation or permutation where arrangement with repetition. Okay? Okay, so ito yung example ng distinguishable permutation. Okay, so sabi rito, how many distinguishable permutations can the letters of the word banana be arranged? Okay, kung mapapansin ninyo, di ba? Sa word na banana, meron tayong letters na nauulit. Okay, pero bago yun, aalamin muna natin kung ilang object or number or ilang letters ang meron tayo. So, dito sa given natin, yung n natin dito is 6. Bakit 6? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So, pero meron tayong naulit na letters. We have R sub 1 here. No, ano yung naulit natin na R sub 1? So, yung A. Right? Ilan yung A natin? So, let us try to count. Meron tayong 3. R sub 2, which is yung letter N. Ilang beses ba naulit yung N? 2. Okay? So, balik tayo rin sa formula natin. Sabi sa distinguishable permutation, paiksiin ko na lang, PD ko na lang. No? So, distinguishable permutation, you have n factorial over r sub 1 factorial, r sub 2 factorial, r sub 3 factorial, ... kung ilan yung mga objects na naulit. So, dito meron tayong dalawang objects. So, r sub 1 to up to r sub 2 lang tayo. So, substitute natin yung value. Meron tayong 6 factorial. Okay. Over yung una natin na ulit na letters, yung R sub 1 natin, meron tayong 3 factorials times 2 factorials. Okay, so then apply natin yung ano, apply natin yung solution, yung long process solution natin. No, so we have 6 factorial, we have 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Divide. No, yung 3 factorial is 3 times 2 times 1. Multiplied by, yung 2 factorial natin is 2 times 1. So again, para madali, gamit tayo ng cancellation method. So nakita natin yung 3 times 2 times 1, cancel out natin yun. So yung matitira ngayon is yung 6 times 5 times 4 over 2 times 1. No? Solve na natin to. You have 6 times 5 will give you 30, times 4 it will give you 120. Right? Then 2 times 1, of course, 2. Alright, so solve natin sila. Okay, so the distinguishable permutation from the word banana is 120 divided 2 will give you 60. So, ganun lang siya sa distinguishable permutation. So, what if naman ang word natin is Philippines? Philippines. Okay. Ilang letters ba ang word na Philippines? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Ako, ang dami. So, meron tayo, ang N natin dito ay 11. Okay. So, unahin natin yung P. Ilang beses na ulit yung P? No, yung R, gawin na natin R sub P. So, 1, 2, 3. Ano pa yung naulit? Yung I. R sub I. So, 1, 2, 3. Meron pa ba? Wala nang naulit, no? So, yun lang. Wala nang naulit. So, ibig sabihin, magkakaroon tayo rito ng permutation, ng distinguishable permutation na 11 factorial over 3 factorial times 3 factorial. Okay? So, gawin siguro natin gamit tayo ng calculator. No, try natin kunin yung kabuang value ng 11 factorial. Alam ko, million yan eh. So, 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Okay. So, kung gagawin kasi natin yun, mahaba yung value. So, try natin siyang paiksiin using cancellation method. So, yung 11 natin, alam natin 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 and times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Yan. So, kung meron kayong calculator dyan, aabot yan ng 39,916,800. Okay, so mamaya, gawin na natin yun. So, 3 factorial. So, syempre, 3 times 2 times 1. Yung isa rin, ganun. 3 times 2 times 1. So, cancel out natin yung 3, 2, 1 para mas madali. Okay? Then, eto, pag kinuha natin kasi yung product ng 3 times 2 times 1, magbibigay ito ng value na 6. So, cancel natin to. Cancel natin yung 6. So, ang matitira ay 11. No, compute na natin yung 11. No, itong 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 times 7. Dahil wala na yung 6, diretso tayo kay 5 times 5 then times 4. So, the distinguishable permutation from the word Philippines is 1,108,800. Okay? So, pwede nyo ulit yan i-recompute using your own calculator. Okay?